Hi, Gary. Thank you.
Great news about Toby.
Yeah, great news. We are happy. We club, we are happy. Toby is happy. I believe also supporters happy. So good news, really good news.
It's already been called by Tottenham fans on social media the Mourinho effect. After maybe over a year of speculation, he's now signed. How much of an influence on that have you had?
Little. I believe little. When I read his comments, the thing that jumps immediately is I couldn't be happier in another place. So I think that's a fundamental thing. He loves it here. He was always happy here. He believes in a better future. He was more than happy to agree. The only thing that maybe I had a little bit of influence on him, maybe the fact that he knows my belief in him, he knows that I think he can be very influential in the team. He played every minute of every match since I arrived, so I think that's a good feeling, 6 matches, playing every minute. But for me the fundamental thing is this quote, I couldn't be happier in another place.
And do you think this could be the start of a kind of domino effect with likes of Jan, his Belgian friend? And
I don't think it's a domino effect. I think it's, every player is a different situation. I think for a player in the last year of contract to sign a contract must be a union of desires. Is the club, is the manager, is the player, is the agent, eventually the family or friends, but must be like a union of desire. And with Toby, that expression of desire come at the same time from every person involved, so he's done. Toby is done. He stays with us.
I know it's very much your desire to make Sunday Tottenham team versus Chelsea team. Can you get away from the Jose Mourinho playing his old club?
Of course. Of course I can. I can. Maybe others, they cannot. Maybe you cannot. I can. For me, it's a game. For me, it's a game. I am 100% Tottenham. I am 100% my club, always. All my career, 100% my club. And no space at all for my previous clubs. My previous clubs, I gave everything to all of them, everything. I kept nothing from me. I gave everything to my previous clubs. But they are my previous clubs. So I give everything I have to my club, and my club is Tottenham. So for me, it's so easy to play that game. Difficult because of the quality of Chelsea, but not difficult for the emotional point of view. Not at all easy.
But having said that, your record, Jose Mourinho's record against your former clubs at home, is very good. Played 13. 112, drawn 1.
You know more than me, because I had no idea. I don't know. I play against Porto. I play against Chelsea. I don't know. I'm not a stats man. But it's so easy for me to say always the obvious. I told the same when we play Manchester United. Before the game, is great to see some people that even now you consider your friends. After the game, the same feeling is good. But during the game, there is not 1 second to think about it, and is not one inch of doubts. I am Tottenham 100%, and the same way I gave everything to make Chelsea supporters smile and be happy, that's exactly the same the same desire I have to give everything to Tottenham fans and to make them smile and be happy, and that's what I want to try on Sunday. Of course, together with my boys, and of course with the help of an amazing stadium.
1 month ago when you came to Spurs, would you have taken needing to win a home game to go into the top four?
Of course, of course. When we arrived, we were 12 points distance. We were obviously closer to the bottom than to the top, but of course we knew it, where we belong, and we knew it, that was a question of time to leave these awful positions and to have an approach. But we were not looking to top four. We never spoke about it. We were just speaking about, let's try to get results and points and see where this situation is going to take us. You know, in this moment we know that we can end the year in the top four, but end of the year is not important. Important is end of season, and this is not just between us and Chelsea. Manchester United is involved, Wolves is involved, there are many other teams involved in this top six, top four fight. So every point is a crucial point, every match is a big match.
Obviously, you know that you're close to Frank, who named you as an inspiration to him. Is this the most difficult period of his managerial career, like one in the last five in the Premier League?
You know, but this happens to everyone. Do you know who is the best manager in the world? He's the one that never lost a match. That guy is the best. When you are a manager, you lose matches. You have difficult moments, but that's the way it is. So I think our life is an accumulation of experiences. I accumulate experiences since 2001 or since 2000. Frank accumulates experiences since last year. I can imagine that after such a fantastic work he did at Derby to lose the playoff final is also an experience that hurts. And this season in Chelsea is having fantastic matches, fantastic results, qualified the team to the next round of the Champions League. He's fourth in this moment. He's fourth in the difficult Premier League. So I think he's doing well. He's doing well.
Final one from me. Glenn Hoddle obviously knows both clubs very well. Says that based on the fan base, the stadium, the training facilities, Tottenham is a bigger club than Chelsea. Would you agree with him?
My club is always the best club in the world. The best, the biggest is always my club. Always.
Get it, Lindsay.
James, just regards to Frank and the job that he's done, given that there was the transfer ban at the start of the season, he's brought a lot of young players through, do you think that being fourth at the moment, he's overachieved at Chelsea?
I don't think it's a question for me. I don't know. I don't know how to answer to you. I know that he's a manager with potential. I know that his young players are some of the best young players in English football. I know that he has a great core of experience and quality players. When you look to William, Alonso, Rudiger, Kante, when you look to all these guys, you are speaking about some of the best players in the Premier League. When you look at the young guys, they are, I think almost all of them now, even full internationals with England, you are speaking about a fantastic squad. So I'm not surprised that they are doing well.
What will you do post-match? Are you going to have a drink? Is that something that you're expecting to do with Frank afterwards?
Don't think so, because our stadium is built in a way where my office is completely on the inside of our private headquarters, and until now I never invite any manager to go there, and I don't think I'm going to do that with Frank, but like I used to say, a big hug before the game and another big hug after the game. That's for sure, independent of results, independent of who is happy. I think our feelings are going to be forever. I will be always grateful to him for what he gave me as a player, and nothing is going to change. I love the guy. I will always love the guy. I hope he loses Sunday.
One final one from me. Do you have an update on Hugo Lloris? I know that he has been training, but what's the latest in his progress of getting back into the team?
He's a champion, and not just a champion of the world. He's also a champion as a professional. Works very, very hard, very brave, accelerates processes, but there are limits of that acceleration of process with such an important injury. But he's doing amazingly well. He's working with a different group of people, since the physios until the goalkeeper coach. He's working really, really hard. And you know, it's difficult to set up a date. I would say February. Probably I will be not far from it if I say February. And of course February goes from the 1st until the 28th or 29th?
29.
29?
This year.
So 29.
George.
Jose, hello. I watched you on Sky Sports earlier this season. You was at Anfield and you said you was worried about Chelsea.
I was good, no?
Very good. But you saw this collapse coming? From this Chelsea collapse, the way you spoke about their defending against big teams?
Well, it's a collapse that keeps them fourth in the Premier League, and that keeps them in the Champions League, playing an amazing knockout against Bayern Munich. If that is a collapse, it's not a bad collapse. They are fine.
But you made some big progress against them in recent weeks, closing down this top four race.
Because we won our matches. In 15 points, we did 15, no? We did 12. Yeah, so we did lots of points, even losing a match, no draws, so we won matches, we did lots of points. When opponents lose some matches, you have the chance to approach. That's a difficulty when you chase, that's a difficulty. It's like Man City. If Man City now, they win 3, 4, 5 matches in a row and Liverpool doesn't lose points, it looks like they are not doing very, very well. But if they do it and Liverpool loses a couple of matches, then it's a different story. We does, and our direct competitors, Chelsea, United, Wolves, Arsenal, with all these good teams, we managed to do 12 points in such a small period of time, and we had an approach.
Are you ahead of where you want to be in the race for the top four? Did you think you could get in the top four?
In terms of the position, I am ahead of where I expected to be. Because you depend always on the results of your opponent, and I couldn't imagine, and I cannot control that Chelsea lost a few matches, that Arsenal lost a couple of matches. The only control that we had was to beat Wolves, and Wolves was in front of us, and now they are behind us. A part of that we cannot control.
And you have a great record managing games. Former players that have become managers. I think you've won 11 out of 12. Do you get an extra kick from managing against players that you used to manage?
I lost against Frank last year.
That was the only one?
Yeah, but I lost.
But do you get an extra buzz out of managing against those players?
No, not at all.
Okay, go to Ellie. And so finish with Charlie.
Tom Giambello is back in training. Is he fit enough to
play part? Yeah. Yeah.
Where do you see kind of his role going forward? Is he going to be the passer alongside defensive midfielder? Is he better than the three for you?
He's a multifunctional midfield player. I'm not telling you the way we are going to play. I'm not even telling you that we are not going to change, because when you get more tactical culture and the players work more time with you, you are able to change. In this moment, clearly you could feel that in the first 2, 3, 4 matches I was very careful of trying to get the players into some stability and some dynamic, but Tanguy can play as a six, as an eight, as a double. He's a player with a lot of quality, just need to be physically strong, mentally adapted to the Premier League. The French League is a complete different story, a complete different profile, but fantastic talent, so we are happy that he can help us. The intensity of the ideas, because the ideas we always tried to bring them to the training pitch. When I say ideas, I say obviously the tactical ideas, but one thing is to do it with lower intensity and lower density, because you played yesterday, because you play tomorrow, and sometimes you don't even do it with real opposition. You do it with what we call passive opposition. In this moment, in this week was the first week where we managed to do it also using the physical adaptations, and we work at the intensity we like to work, which is an intensity very, very high, because this is the way we try to play, either defensively or offensively. So was fundamentally about that. And between January, February, I think we are going to have a couple of more weeks like that, unless we have some FA Cup replay to play, and then we interrupt one of these possible weeks. But if we don't have draws in our match against Middlesbrough, and eventually in the next round if we win, then we will be fine, because we are going to have more weeks to work.
Okay, finish with Charlie.
Just on that, having a full week, do you think we'll see a slightly different looking side on Sunday, just having had that benefit?
I hope the team improves, yes. I think we are improving step by step, but fundamentally we are improving with the matches we play more than the training sessions that we have, are the matches that are bringing us to do correct things, to do mistakes, to analyze the mistakes, to try to go over the mistakes, which we did, of course, a lot since I arrived. Another thing is to have a training week to work, so I would be disappointed if the team doesn't answer well to the quality they gave me, because they gave me lots of quality and commitment and desire in this week of work.